debate this issue?
The question... Honourable David Cunliffe.
Mr Chairman, thank you. I rise to take a very short call in this debate to record my support for the position that the opposition has set forward, which is to conditionally support this bill proceeding to a select committee process of not less than 2 months. Sir, it's worth recording that the government's preference was a very shoddy 1 month process, and that under discussion with the opposition. Oh, that was a mistake. Oh, now it's a mistake. Like so much else, Mr. Speaker, that has been happening lately, like the appointments of senior and very sensitive public service positions, like the protection of personal private information, and a whole lot of other mistakes, Mr. Chairman. Back to the bill, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Speaker, Labor supports in principle the shifting of the burden of proof. This is an issue that my colleague Ian Lees-Galloway, our Associate Health Spokesperson, has spent some time on over the years, and he has led a debate within our caucus which shows the value in ensuring that those who would wish to put on the market potentially psychoactive substances are required to meet the full cost and the full standards of medical integrity providing for those tests. Mr. Chairman, I'd also wish to just briefly record, as a Member of Parliament with a large Pacific Island community in my electorate, the sensitivity around the issue of kava taking. It is a traditional substance. It is part of traditional routines, and we will want assurance from... Well, we'll wait for the Minister to go on record when he's in the chair, and we'll look forward to that. We will want to have assurances from the government that traditional cultural practices will not be inappropriately affected by this legislation, Mr. Chairman. And I look forward to hearing Pacific members opposite taking up that banner in support of those constituencies. It seems to be the Labor members so far who have been championing that issue on behalf of our Pacific communities. So summing up, Mr. Speaker, and I don't wish to detain the House, Labor conditionally supports the passage of this bill through to the select committee process. We hope that the public will have as much opportunity as possible to make submissions. The committee will carefully consider those. It is strange, sir, that the government, which has had this bill in development for such a very long time, has brought it to the House with such a rushed timetable. Only 2 months it has now been clarified, shall we say, and that against the normal practice of a full 6 month a select committee hearing timetable. So that is not ideal, sir, and it is part of a trend that New Zealanders are seeing where this government is playing fast and loose with the legislative process. And New Zealanders, sir, are becoming increasingly concerned, increasingly disappointed in a government which is not protecting their rights, not protecting their rights to have their say on legislation, not protecting their rights to the privacy of their personal information, not protecting their rights to keep them from the prying eyes of the state. And New Zealanders are asking what it is going to look like to live in John Key's New Zealand in a couple of years' time if these trends continue. It is something, sir, that all New Zealanders would wish to guard against. So, sir, while we have no problem with the principle of this bill, which is the reversing of the burden of proof here to ensure that the proposed manufacturers and retailers of potentially psychoactive drugs are meeting the costs and the due diligence of proving their safety, we are seriously concerned about the shortage of time for submissions, and we've been very active in pushing back on the government for any further shortening. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
The question is that the motion be agreed to. Those of that opinion will say aye. Contrary, no. The ayes have it. Call on Government Order of the Day number 2.
Child Support Amendment Bill, third reading.
Honourable Peter Dunn.
Mr. Speaker, I move with a great deal of pleasure that the Child Support Amendment Bill